Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Lakes, Laurie Mahaffey. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Bulavant. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78.
Get ready up here. You look dandy. You look very chic, smart bunch. Let's say hello to Debbie Sorensen and Harold Biani. Debbie. Debbie, the current champ, has won $450. And where are we? Oh, we haven't met Harold yet, have we?
No, you haven't.
Tell us a little bit about Harold Biani.
Well, Harold Biani is an employee of the County of Los Angeles. He's an investigator.
Yeah.
And he's married. He has three beautiful daughters. I almost blew it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are their names?
Autumn, April, and Amber.
Autumn, April, and Amber.
Mm-hmm.
I assume that one of them was born in the fall of the year?
No.
Oh. One of them was born in the spring?
Yes, somewhere around that way.
That was Autumn.
Uh-huh.
Yes. April was born in the fall.
May. Want to try for Amber?
And Amber was born in a closet.
No.
No.
Fireplace.
In a fireplace.
Right.
Going to be one of them shows, I can tell right now. We'll start it right after we do this message for you. Here we go. I push the button, reveal round one questions for Harold's choice.
A, please.
A for April, right?
Right.
Okay.
A for April.
And
born
Autumn.
In a closet.
And
Jeff
Amber.
Said, my wife is the world's worst cook. She's burned one thing too many. So last night, I burned the blank. That's what happened. My wife, world's worst cook, burned one thing too many, so last night I burned the blank. Right. All right, Harold Biani. Jeff said, my wife is the world's worst cook. She's burned...
I laughed in London.
What?
I'm sorry, what...
Huh? Oh,
just chatting.
Everything's okay. All right. My wife is the world's worst cook. She's burned one thing too many. So last night, I burned the blank.
The stove.
The stove. Okay. She burned the stove. That means she couldn't do much cooking after that. What do you say to this?
Harold may do all right in this. The stove.
Stove. Okay, Harold, you got one.
The stove and not a moment
the whole
too
stove.
Soon.
Got rid of the whole thing there. Chuck? What do you got?
It's doing so good, and it doesn't even begin with A. It says stove.
Stove. Isn't that funny? You know, I thought everybody was going to say either the house or the kitchen or, you know, have a big conflagration. But everybody's saying stoves. Last night, I burned the stove. That's what they're all saying.
It's got one in it. Kitchen.
Kitchen. Oh. All right, Richard, we're up to you.
Kitchen.
That's two kitchens. Three stoves?
I was going to say the wife, but that sounded too
Yeah, that would be a little difficult.
I said the kitchen.
The kitchen. Three stoves, three kitchens, evenly divided there. Debbie, are you ready?
Yes.
This is it. Muggsy said.
Muggsy.
My neighborhood is really tough.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you how tough it is. Last time I had an exterminator over, the roaches blanked him. Last time I had an exterminator over, the roaches blanked him. Tough neighborhood.
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay. Last time I had an exterminator over, the roaches blanked him. Got the idea, Debbie?
Sure do.
Okay, we're ready for you. Muggsy said my neighborhood is really tough. Last time I had an exterminator over, the roaches blanked him.
Mugged him?
Mugged him. Okay. They all ganged up on him.
Yes.
I have never in my life heard of an exterminator mugging a roach.
No, I haven't.
Turnabout is fair play. He killed him.
Killed him, right. That's the
roach.
That's right. Kill a roach and then turn about his fair play, right.
Right. The last time he was so tough he came in, they exterminated him.
Him. Now that's two for those.
They yes. put him away.
Put him away, that's three so far. We have three of those. Well, last time we had a division of the upper and lower tier. Let's see if it happens again this time. We're up to you. Last time I had an exterminator over the roaches, blanked him. What'd they do to him, Laurie?
They mugged him.
They mugged him.
Yeah.
3-1 the score.
Killed.
They killed him. The roaches ganged up on him.
I just wanted to say something. Isn't it funny that they all said stove and we all said kitchen?
Yes.
It's like an energy thing passes, isn't it?
Yeah. No, you're the only weirdo.
Oh, no. I said exterminated.
Exterminated. That's so there we are. 3-1 the score at the end of round one. We now go to round two and ask Harold Biani if he wants A or B.
B for Biani.
B for Biani. Okay. Stella said. That new doctor just down... Oh, that's right. Just the bottom tier here, because he matched the upper tier last time. Thank you.
Yes, Ollie.
That new doctor is weird. I told him I had butterflies in my stomach, and he told me to eat a blank. Weird doctor.
Oh, am I glad I'm not answering that question.
Oh, that's an easy one. I told him I had butterflies in my stomach. He told me to eat a blank.
I don't think that's not good.
That's a good one. No, that's a good one.
I thought of that. I thought
butterflies
of that.
In my stomach. All right. Harold, what do you say to this? Stella said that new doctor is weird. I told him I had butterflies in my stomach. He told me to eat a blank.
I'm torn between two. Eat a flower.
It's a lovely thought, because butterflies
are
attracted by flowers, and they sit on flowers, and they eat the pollen and all that, but it's a loser.
Oh. He has a terrific voice, though, doesn't he?
What was your other answer?
Annette.
Annette. Okay, Laurie, you're up first.
Annette, my dear.
Annette.
Sorry.
Well... He had two in his head, didn't he? A net and a...
Net.
A net. Two of those. All right. Now listen, maybe... You never can tell here, Harold. Don't give up, Harold. Go.
Eat a caterpillar.
Eat a caterpillar.
But I keep him company.
Well, it was a lovely thought to eat a flower. Thank you for that lovely thought, Harold. Now we've got this lovely thought for you. Oh, good. Hello there. Glad to hear that. Glad to hear you back with us again here. Hello. Debbie, are you ready?
Yes,
two to tie, three to win. Fred said television is really getting ridiculous. Yesterday, I even saw a blank with a laugh track. You don't play. You're the only one. Television is really getting ridiculous. Yesterday, I even saw a blank with a laugh track.
Goodies. Yeah, I
you got three goodies?
I only have two.
That's it?
That's it. Okay.
Right?
That's four.
You matching that with a laugh track?
All right. Here we go with Debbie. Ready, Debbie? Fred said television is really getting ridiculous. Yesterday, I even saw a blank with a laugh track.
First thing that came to my mind was a newscast.
Newscast. Okay. This is Walter Cronkite laughing it up.
Well, that's funny, though. That should have a laugh track. I said a police story.
A police story, yes, with a laugh track. All right.
We got a little ESP going here. Newscast.
Newscast. Score is now 3-2. One more to tie. Chuck?
The definitive answer.
The definitive answer.
Yeah. Sermonette.
Sermonette. With a laugh track.
The not-so-definitive answer.
Well, no, I think it's an inspired answer.
I think that's a
Richard?
A news show.
News show. Another good one there. Score is now tied. 3-3. And Joyce, the fate of these two people is in your hands.
I got the whole
whole world in my hands.
Yeah. I feel so sorry for you. I really do.
Well, you needn't fear. A news show.
News show. The Debbie wins again. Right down there, if you would, please. Harold Biani, it was a pleasure to meet you and your family.
My pleasure.
And we're going to send some gifts your way. They may be able to use some. You might be able to use some. Thank you for being with us here on Magic 78. Harold Biani, there he goes. Hello there. Third time around, eh? There it is. You know how it goes, Debbie. We polled an audience, said write down your best answer to this. Give me a blank. $500 if you match the most popular. $250 for the second most popular. And $100 for matching the third. Now, whom do you call on this time?
Lori.
Give me a break.
Give me a break is one.
Joyce.
Give me a chance.
Give me a chance is two.
And Dick.
Give me a sailor. That's a very famous play.
Is that really
famous?
What?
Play.
It must be of a vintage era, dear.
Oh, no, Jack Mulhall was in it.
Jack Mulholland?
Yes.
Laura LaPlante?
Laura LaPlante was
yes,
in it?
Yes, and Milton Sills was in it too, I believe. Milton Sills was in that, wasn't he?
Yes, yes, he did all of the choreography.
So those are the three possibilities. Give me a sailor, give me a break, and give me a chance. Now, what do you say to that, Debbie?
Don't say, give me a sailor.
Laurie's helped me out twice before. I'll go, give me a break.
Give me a break,
give
is
a
what
break,
Laurie said.
Give me a break.
Give me a break. Let's find out if we got a break up there. May we see the $100 response?
Sailor.
No.
Give me a hand, sailor.
Give me a hand, sailor. Yes, that's it. That's it. Now, let's see the $250 number. Give me a break. You've got it. $250.
It is.
All right,
sailor.
We're going to find out right now what's under the big one. What do you think?
Sailor.
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 Sailor. Now, wait a minute. We had 100 little old ladies from Pasadena.
They're just
all
the
right,
one.
Slide it and don't show me your sailor. Give me a kiss.
We didn't have that. The same thing as sailor.
That's what you had in mind. Give me a kiss, sailor. No, okay. You got $250. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $2,500. Howsomever, Debbie, come with me over here. Step into my office here. And, well, you've done this. You're going to do that. It's got to make one complete revolution. If it stops in the gold stars, you'll be paying for double the money or $5,000. Let's see what's going to happen here. Yes, it looks. Well, Laurie, let's have a go at it for $2,500. Good luck to you, Debbie. This is it. Worth $2,500. Celebrity blank. Celebrity blank. Celebrity blank. Okay, you give us the answer that matches hers, and we give you $2,500. What do you say to that?
Celebrity sweepstakes. Yeah.
That was a show that was on and had a well-deserved demise, I believe. Yes, Laurie, she says celebrity sweepstakes.
Was that before my time?
Yes, it was. Oh. Yeah, you don't remember it, do you? Because you're so young.
No, I don't remember it.
You're really 16, aren't you?
Going on 17.
Going on 17.
Getting older every year.
Yes.
However, I have heard of it before.
Oh! Okay, good luck to all of you. $3,300 for Debbie Sorensen. Now this message for you.
Today's consolation prizes are first. From Coty, a gift collection of Masumi fragrances. Masumi, the essence of inner beauty by Coty. And a twin-size Maxipedic by Simmons, designed in cooperation with an orthopedic surgeon. Featured a built-in bed board and a box spring for super comfort and support from Simmons. And a Master Mechanic shop vac to fix up water or dry materials inside or out. Master Mechanic shop vac exclusively from True Value Hardware Store. And fill your tote from your own Tic Tac tree. Enjoy a double mouth like Hello Tic Tac by Ferrero USA. There's more Blindy Bikes coming up for the star of our show, Gene Labor.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Let's all welcome Jill Kurligan. Hello, Jill.
Hi.
Can everybody say your name?
Yes.
Kurligan.
Yes.
What kind of name is Kurligan?
You have to ask my husband.
Yes. All right. It's an Irish name, right?
It sounds good.
Where are you from, Jill?
Panorama City.
Hey, where?
Panorama City.
Panorama City. I have no idea where that is. I'm not really that familiar.
Van Nuys.
Oh, Van Nuys, yeah. It's in the Dreaded Valley, isn't it? Yes.
Unfortunately.
Yes, it's beautiful. Right. The valley. What else you want to tell us about you, Jill?
Well, I'm a retired manicurist turned sales rep.
Yeah.
And I've been happily married for almost 5 years.
Well, we'll change all that, won't we? What does Mr. Kurligan do?
Custom car paint.
Custom car painting?
Yeah.
That's an interesting job. He must have run across a lot of antiques in doing that. Are you ready to play A or B here?
Sure, A, please.
Okay, Jill, anything you say. Is your husband with you?
Yes.
Okay, I'll get an estimate on my car job while he's here. Unlucky Louise said, yesterday I bought a living bra. Just my luck. It blanked me. I bought a man.
Got it.
It blanked me. Quick!
As a flash.
You've had experiences with these things, I
yes,
take it.
Yes, yes. Living bras and other right. things.
It blanked me. All right. Okay, ready down here. Ready up there. Jill, are you ready?
Sure.
Okay, Unlucky Louise said yesterday, I bought a living bra. Then she said, just my luck, it blanked me.
It has to be, it ate her.
A living bra?
Ate.
It ate me? Well?
All right, sweetheart.
The weirdos are over here, yes. Jill, you see. The normies are over there. What do you say?
I say whatever turns her on. No, it choked her.
Choked her, yeah. It was alive. It went around her neck and choked her, right.
Hello, darling.
Yes.
Did you say ate her?
Yeah, you were the first one finished there.
Oh, yes, but I didn't say ate. I said he just took a little nip out of her, just bit her.
Bit her.
That's
a match. That would be the first step, yes?
I said it killed her.
Killed her.
Oh, it's so butch.
I love the dimple in your cheek, Chuck. Or the chuck in your cheek, dimple. Hey, Laurie, yesterday I bought a living bra, just my luck, it blanked me. What do you say to that? You got anything to say about that?
Well, yes, I have an answer here for you, and it's killed. It's not the right one.
Killed. All right. Now, bought a living bra, and it
bit
me. There's another one, two for Jill. Jill Kurligan now has two.
You know why that happened?
Why?
Because she couldn't find anything to feed it.
Oh.
Bitter.
Okay, you got three there. Debbie, you ready for yours?
Yes.
Here it is. Daddy said, this year, my kids made my birthday present in arts and crafts class. Was it painful? It was a pair of shorts made out of blank. The kids, they thought they were doing the old man a favor.
Yeah.
Made him a pair of shorts out of blank. Very painful experience.
Arts and crafts.
Arts and crafts. Yeah, the operative word, it was painful. The shorts made out of blank. That's enough. Time's up. Thank you very much. Arts. Goodbye. Debbie. Danny said this year my kids made my present in arts and crafts class. And was it painful? It was a pair of shorts made out of blank.
Paper mache?
Papier-mâché.
Yes.
Paper-mâché. Would that hurt? I don't know. Well, no, let's see. Now, if it would be stiff, you'd just walk funny. It wouldn't hurt. Because you see, after it dries up and it hardens, you just
They're
walk
too tight,
like
that's the trick.
Oh no, we
it
made
might,
it a size
it might be uncomfortable,
38.
Though,
yes.
I said tacks.
Out of tacks.
Tacks. That wouldn't be.
They strung them all together.
A whole pair of shorts made out of tacks. Well, really, Mr. Martin, I'm Oh, speed up! A balsa wood.
Balsa wood. Dumb. That's two dumb answers in a row.
I got a good one, Uncle James.
Go.
Steel wool.
Very good. Excellent. Laurie, have you got a good one?
Not as good as that one. Wood.
Wood would hurt. Wood would indeed hurt. And what have you
this
got?
This is something you always have in arts and crafts. Sandpaper.
Sandpaper.
That's a good one.
So there we have the end of round one, 3-0 the score. And now we got this for America. Wasn't it grand? Yes. Say yes. Thank you. Gene Reviter, join us next time. Match Game 78. Good. Oh, these are the people you'll see next time.
Richard Deacon. Russ Summers. Charles Nelson Riley. Patty Duke-Aston. Bob Barker. And Fanny Fly.
Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.